Hello everyone, this is your friend Professor Iqbal here. Once again, I welcome all of you to my YouTube channel, My Grammar Classes. And in this episode of lecture, we will particularly focus on the usage of conjunctions. Okay, first of all, let us understand what is a conjunction. A conjunction is a word that joins two parts of a sentence. The literary meaning of conjunction is to join. To conjunct is a verb which means to join or to bring together. Now, conjunctions, they are of two types, subordinating conjunctions and coordinating conjunctions. Now, we will see that what can be done in case of coordinating conjunction, in case of subordinating conjunction. Let us begin our lecture by taking some examples of coordinating conjunction. Now, what is a coordinating conjunction? A coordinating conjunction is a conjunction which joins two parts of a sentence which are grammatically equal in rank. And they are seven in number. Okay, they are seven in number. Fanboys. You can easily remember them by the name fanboys. F stands for, A stands for and, N stands for nor, B stands for but, O stands for or, Y stands for react, S stands for so. They are seven in number and there is one easy way to remember them by a word fanboys. Now let us take some examples so that you will come to know. First example, she doesn't waste a drop of gas for it is very expensive. Here the meaning of for is because. Next example we will take. Radha and Rani are sisters. Radha and Rani are sisters. Neither she had nor she left. Neither she had nor she left. Again, let us go to the next one. So this is fan. Now we will see the usage of but. Boys, that is but. Ram is clever but poor. He is intelligent but arrogant. Gold is precious but costly. Now let us go to the next conjunction. Or. Do you like tea or coffee? Would you have sandwich or pizza? Now let us go to yet. Take some examples of yet. She is allergic to cats, yet she has four of them. She is allergic to spicy food, yet she has spicy food. Last one is so. She could not go to school.